Perhaps it all gets a little bit boring. I've published yesterday that circuit about the two transistor radio with one field effect transistor, and this is a kind of demonstration about what you can expect. I've now soldered in this coil. You can see a cardboard roll with these windings. And we are now with that coil on the, say, the first part of shortwave, and that's around 2 megahertz. So 2 up to 3 megahertz, I think that this coil works there. Of course, when I don't stick in that ferrite rod, then the inductance goes up very substantially, and we are on the medium wave band, and there's nothing, there are no transmitters any longer, in the Netherlands at least. So let's see what this radio can bring. I've now connected an indoor antenna 4 meter in my room via a 18 picofarad capacitor to keep the quality of this coil good, so that the antenna doesn't load the coil. And these are good ideas for coils. PVC tube. My experience is, and I cannot prove it, but I think it at least, that the yellow type of this PVC tube works better than the gray type. Perhaps there are other materials used, fillers or whatever. I cannot prove it. It's perhaps only an idea anyway. This is a good way to make coils. Of course, you can make them big on a toilet roll. In general, that's better for an antenna coil, a big open air coil. But for instance, for an oscillator coil, that could be a problem. That coil is in fact too big for an oscillator coil. The quality factor is in fact too high, and that means that the frequency band that the oscillator will cover with such a big coil will be somewhat more limited. So for an oscillator, this is a better coil, or even such a coil, or a piece of this, such a coil. Anyway, there's also much more information in all the videos that I've pinned to the preceding video about that radio. So let's listen somewhat. At first, this strange sound. And because there is no fading correction, you will hear radio stations getting stronger. Then they weaken, the radio signal weakens. Has everything to do with the atmosphere and atmospheric influences. They cause fading. You can find that surely on the World Wide Web or Wikipedia. So that the first thing that we can receive. A good idea, for instance, to get more out of this radio is to use a small speaker and a big speaker and switch between them. The reason is that this speaker is not able to reproduce the low frequencies, and that makes shortwave radio stations that you can better hear them. They are better audible. So I can show that. This is the big speaker. Has also certain properties, but you can hear more hum on the background, and here all that hum is gone. So something to take in account. Let's move the knob and listen. Here you hear the first radio stations, and you can immediately hear that you hear two stations at the same time. That has to do with the selectivity. The selectivity is not enough in this case. So this coil, in combination with that variable capacitor, doesn't have an extreme sharp peak, and that is also not possible, because on shortwave the frequency band from shortwave transmitter stations is approximately 5000 hertz. The bandwidth approximately 5000 or 6000 or 8000 hertz, and there must be space in between for another radio station. That means that all these radio stations, you hear them at the same time, and that can only be overcome with the help of a super heterodyne radio receiver. And this is what we call in the Netherlands a rechtuit receiver, literally translated a straight receiver, and the other principle is the super heterodyne receiver. Let's listen further. This is perhaps interesting. I think this is Radio China. Radio China is always very, very strong. It has a very strong medium shortwave transmitter. So, and also now the selectivity is not good enough. You hear Radio China, and I also hear German on the background. Perhaps that's the same station, of course. Yes, this is the same radio station. That it's Radio China with a German lesson. This is another station, surely. And due to the fading, you can hear that it goes away, it comes back, etc. And a lot of hum. So, two radio stations. I switch back to this small speaker. Another radio pops up. Another station pops up. And due to the fading, they sometimes appear, and 1 minute later they disappear. Now it fades away. And at the same time, another station on the same frequency or near the same frequency can go up, and the other radio transmitter station is not received any longer. These are two broadcasts. And this is interesting to show. When you hear this, this is a typical sound when you tune in. It's a kind of roar, and this is a typical sound that follows approximately on 2 megahertz, between 2 and say 2.5 megahertz, so the very first part of the shortwave band. When you make such a simple radio, and when you make other radios, superheads or so, and you tune in, you'll hear that kind of roar. And now it's not so strong due to fading, but it gets so much stronger, and it fades away, etc, etc. This is also, I could also receive this. Very strange. The amplification is now at the maximum. Let's see what happens when we turn it back. And you can hear that it's... that you can already receive it at the maximum audio amplification. And furthermore, perhaps interesting, it could be that the radio oscillates. And that's bad in a certain way, but it's also good because when it oscillates, it's possible, sometimes possible, to receive other radio stations compared to the stations that you normally can receive. So let's go away here. Romania, Radio Romania. Two broadcasting stations. They tell their frequencies, but I cannot understand exactly what they say. At least it's Radio Romania. So, it's a kind of art to receive, to get good radio receiving results with this radio. But anyway, no problem. Let's see what happens, for instance, when we stick in here that ferrite rod. That means that the frequency band of the antenna coil goes down. So, now there is inductance, more inductance. Due to the fact that rod is sticked in. And it also means that when we tune in here, we get another, spreading of the radio stations. Compared to the situation when that rod is not in the coil. And perhaps we can even receive some radio stations on the lower side of that band. Better because the quality for those lower frequencies goes up due to that ferrite rod. Now we are here. This is, I think, a Russian station, and because the ferrite rod is sticked far into the coil, this must be on a lower frequency than, say, 3 MHz or so. I don't understand a word of it, but anyway. Let's tune in further. Well, that's a bad result. So there's here, only here, is that one and only radio station. Oh, perhaps it's Japanese, I don't know. At least we can say that this frequency is received properly with enough strength, field strength, on that 4 meter long indoor antenna. And there are no other radio stations active at the moment, I think. So that you only hear this station on that specific frequency. Now we are back on the beginning of shortwave. Radio China. So again, it's the final experiment. Stick this rod in again. Perhaps I can get somewhat better results here. No. That's not the case. So, you must not be afraid of hum and noise, etc., etc., when you do these experiments. Anyway. Want to retrieve that station again? And I thought I heard English or American. Anyway, it shows only, this video only shows what you can expect. And of course, it's all fun. And when you find a stable station and in a language that you can understand, you could have a quite good radio.